Welcome to PreMath. In this video, we have got this scalene triangle ABC, as you can see in this given diagram, such that its side length AB is 3 power 2 units. The side length BC is 4 square units. And finally, the side AC is being represented by X squared. And moreover, this angle ABC is 2 times alpha, whereas this angle ACB is alpha. And now our task is to find the value of X. Please don't forget to give a thumbs up and subscribe. And please keep in mind that this figure may not be 100% true to the scale. Let's go ahead and get started, and here's our very first step. Let's make an observation. We can see this angle is 2 times alpha, and this angle is just the alpha. So therefore, we are going to draw some auxiliary lines to make our job simple. As you can see in this next step, I have created this line AD, such that this angle CAD has got to be alpha as well. And now let's focus on this triangle ADC, and we can see that this triangle is an isosceles triangle, since this angle is alpha and this angle is alpha as well. So therefore, we conclude that this side AD is going to be equal to this side CD. These two sides are equal in length. And now let's recall the exterior angle theorem. According to this angle, the exterior angle of a triangle is equal to the sum of two opposite interior angles, as you can see in this given diagram. Here we can see this angle C is our exterior angle, whereas our angles A and B are opposite interior angles, such that angle C equals to A plus B. And here we can see our this angle ADB is our exterior angle, and that is going to be equal to the sum of these two opposite interior angles alpha and alpha. So therefore, this angle has got to be 2 times alpha. And now let's focus on this other triangle ABD. And we can see that this is also an isosceles triangle, since this angle is 2 times alpha and this angle is 2 times alpha as well. So therefore, we conclude that this side AB is going to be equal to this side AD. And now let's make an observation. We can see this 3 power 2 is same as 9, and this side BC is 4 power 2, that is equal to 16. And now this side length equal to this side length. We know this side length is 9, then this side length has got to be 9 as well, and this side length is equal to this side CD as well, so this is going to be 9 as well. And now let's make an observation. We can see that this whole BC length is 16, and this CD length is 9. So therefore, this remaining BD length has got to be 16 minus 9 is going to give us 7 units. And now in this next step, I have dropped this perpendicular AE on this side BD. And now let's make an observation. We can see that this side length equal to this side length. So therefore, this triangle ABD is an isosceles triangle, and this AE is our perpendicular. So therefore, this perpendicular is going to bisect this side BD into two equal parts. In other words, BE segment is going to be equal to ED segment, and our whole this BD segment is 7. So therefore, this BE segment is going to be 7 divided by 2. And this ED segment is going to be 7 divided by 2 as well. And furthermore, I'm going to label this perpendicular AE as our height lowercase h. And now let's focus on this right triangle AEB. And we are going to apply the Pythagorean theorem on this triangle. And here's our Pythagorean theorem: a square plus b square equal to c square. And in our case, our hypotenuse is 9, whereas our two other legs are lowercase h n7 divided by 2. So let's go ahead and fill in the blanks in this Pythagorean formula. So we got h square plus 7 divided by 2 whole square equals to 9 square. Let's simplify. We can write h square, and this is going to give us 49 divided by 4 equals to 81. And now I'm going to move this part on the other side. And now let's tweak 81. 81 could be written as 324 divided by 4. So therefore we can write down h square equals to 324 divided by 4 minus 49 divided by 4, such that we have the common denominator of 4. So therefore h square is going to be equal to 324 minus 49 all over 4. And if we simplify furthermore, h square value is going to be 275 divided by 4. So thus our h square value turns out to be 275 divided by 4. And now we are going to focus on this other right triangle AEC. And now let's make an observation. We can see that this whole EC length is going to be 9 plus 7 divided by 2. So I can write down 9 plus 7 divided by 2. And now we can tweak 9. 9 could be written as 18 divided by 2 plus 7 divided by 2. And if we add these two fractions, that is going to give us 18 plus 7 is going to make 25 divided by 2. So therefore this whole EC length turns out to be 25 divided by 2. And now we are going to apply the Pythagorean theorem on this triangle as well. And here's our Pythagorean theorem once again. A square plus b square equal to c square. And here our hypotenuse is AC. I am going to label this hypotenuse as y, such that we can see that y is going to be equal to x square. And our two other legs are 25 divided by 2 and lowercase h. Let's go ahead and fill in the blanks in this Pythagorean formula. So we got h square plus 25 divided by 2 whole square equals to our hypotenuse is y square. Let's simplify furthermore. We can write h square, our value is 275 divided by 4. I'm going to substitute that value, 275 divided by 4 plus 25 divided by 2 square is going to be 625 divided by 4 equals to y square. And if we add the left hand side, that is going to give us 275 plus 625 divided by 4 equals to y square. And we can see if we add this numerator part, that is going to give us 900. So therefore we can write y square equals to 900 divided by 4. So therefore y square is going to be equal to 225. And I'm going to undo this square by taking a square root on both sides. So therefore our y value turns out to be 15 units. So thus our y value turns out to be 15 units. But we know that y equals to x square. And furthermore, y equals to 15. So I'm going to substitute 15 over here. So therefore, we can write 15 equals to x square. And I'm going to undo this square on both sides. And here we can see this square and square root undo each other. So therefore, our x value turns out to be square root of 15 units. So thus, after all the calculations and manipulations, our x value turns out to be square root of 15 units. And that's our final answer. Thanks for watching, and please don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more exciting videos. Bye.